Hey, poor guy with the Blackstone. Hello. Tonight, it's a Saturday night. It's windy out here in Oklahoma. So the wind's coming from there, so we're over here, and we're good to go. We're doing poor man's Philly cheesesteaks on the Blackstone. Steakums. All right. I don't know if they're poor man's, but how much were they, sweetheart? Like $8.99 or something like that? But you get 21 in them. We're going to have these on the Blackstone. Sorry about the traffic noise, of course. And we're using these rolls, which are soft and oh so delicious. And Sargento pepper jack cheese. As you can tell, I bought 24 slices. We like cheese. Now, this will be my third time making these, and I've learned a little bit since then that they cook real quick. Real quick.
Dip, potato chip.
So I haven't even started the Blackstone. I'm starting it now. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and put them on before it actually heats up because they cook really, really quick. I did spray a little bit of canola oil on there. Actually, quite a bit, as you can see. So we'll go ahead and, those of you that have never seen these, I'll show you what they look like. Here, can you take these, sweetheart? Thank you. They're basically, you know, kind of like deli meats or formed meat. Thank you. And they got just these like little thin layers of paper between them. And this is what you do. Try to get them apart, which is a little time consuming. I think that's where the problems I run into previously is that turning on the Blackstone first, by the time I opened the last one, they were pretty well done. So we're just going to basically scramble them all together after they get cooked and pile them on these rolls. But as you can see, they're frozen, and it's a little bit of a pain in the butt to get them undone. I guess if you're doing a video, you could plan ahead a little bit better and kind of separate all of them. But I don't know, I'm not a professional. So since my last video, I did the, what did we do?
We got a mic.
Oh, we got a mic. Yeah, it's on my hat, actually. So you're going to hear the car noise. But in all my other videos, if anyone has ever watched them, there's a lot of noise from the Blackstone. So in between, you know, Tori recording me and me standing over here, you all know it's like you can hardly hear what I'm saying. So the mic wasn't too expensive. What was it, $50?
Yeah.
So we're going to try it out because I think good things are going to happen for poor guy the Blackstone very soon. Yeah, there's that. So, I mean, you can see the Blackstone's not even really heated up, and they're already thawing out. So it doesn't take much to get these boys going. So it's a windy day in Oklahoma. It's Saturday, night before Mother's Day. And I'm going to show you what we like to do. This is a real simple recipe. Or as I said earlier, a real simple recipe.
That was legitness.
Yeah, it was.
Anyway. I think we got paused there for a second. I'm back. Anyway, so you can see how these are cooking up real quick. Before you know it, it kind of looks like a mess right now, which it actually does. But as soon as it heats up, they'll start crisping up a little bit and get the cheese ready.
Dip, potato chip.
So last time I did this, we had bought six of those rolls.
Toasty!
And they were really good, but they were overflowing, and I had poor Aiden helping me out. He was holding the bun, and I was trying to put these in as and the cheese and all the just melting all over the poor guy's skin, and oh, it was just a nightmare for him. His poor guy is still scarred, I think, from it. So we learned another lesson. Let's get more rolls, make more sandwiches. So that'll probably work out better, I think, hopefully. Although I'm not sure who wants to hold the buns. Okay.
Or we can start eating a little bit more.
My honey's not afraid. So far we haven't had a motorcycle go by, so Frodo's not chasing. Oh yeah.
I got a bad feeling about this.
I should have showed you the marinade, or not the marinade, the au jus. That's a big part of this.
Yeah.
The au jus, actually, I think, did you show it in the last video?
I did.
It's a little jug, it's called Johnny's, and, you know, again, we're in Oklahoma, so I don't know if that's available everywhere, but we found that, I think I mentioned it before, we found that at, oops, I think I just hit my microphone, found that at Crest up in Oklahoma City, and that stuff, Tori doesn't like it, but it makes it, so you go to, basically, it's like, kind of like a French dip you might get at Arby's, but instead of Swiss, we got pepper jack, which gives it a lot more flavor. So when these get all cooked up, we're going to separate them into piles and put the cheese on it. And that's pretty much it. Everything goes by real quick. I think this was the key. You know, kind of like when you're a non-professional, you learn as you go when you're cooking with the Blackstone, but that's what I have. That's what I've done over the last year and a half, is kind of learn from my mistakes, and there's nothing wrong with that. Now, is there? There's Sebastian. Tomorrow's Mother's Day, so we're going to celebrate all the moms. We got a day planned, and I'll do another video tomorrow on our quesadillas, the way we like them here at the house. They're very basic, and the marinade for that, again, I don't know if you can get that everywhere in the United States, but we can get it here, and we like it a lot. Rumpy, you're going to have to move. I don't want you to get burnt.
Dip, potato chip.
So let's start to pile these. See if we can get some kind of idea of what we're going to use per sandwich. Try to portion it out a little bit.
Nine,
right. Yeah, we did some garage selling. Here in the wonderful land of Chickasha, Oklahoma, I think probably most communities do these, where, you know, it's a big weekend for garage sales, a lot of people have them. We picked up some good stuff today. We picked up tomorrow, if you stay tuned, you'll see what I got. Okay. How many is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Rumpy?
Okay.
Rumpy likes to stay right underneath our feet when we're cooking because he knows that we're going to drop something and he's going to get it. He's like a land shark, that dog. And I'll tell you what. He is fast. He is faster than any other dog we have when something falls on the floor. And, but this, you know, this is all hot stuff. I don't want him to get burnt. As you can see, these are very close to being done. And now that the Blackstone is heated up. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to start putting the cheese on before. And we have a lot of cheese. Last time we made 6 of these, and we used all 24 slices of cheese. And that's my intention this time, too. So these, like I said, if you're going to make a bunch of sandwiches, don't turn the Blackstone on. Either right at the beginning or put them all on there and turn it on. Because these cook, if that thing's up to temperature, by the time you put your first one on, you're going to end up burning them. Trust me, I learned that from experience. There we go. He went the wrong way today.
Mission failed. We'll get him next time.
Good old Frodo. He likes to chase the motorcycles, just the motorcycles. Must like the sound of them or the freedom that comes with having a motorcycle. Maybe, I don't know. He wants to have one someday. Have a Harley with a chick on the back. Maybe not. So, as you can tell, I'm not a healthy cooker. You very seldomly see me using any vegetables. We do have onions going in the house because Aiden and Don like sautéed onions. I do them on the Blackstone quite often, but with this much food on it, it's a little difficult to get these things cooked without burning them. Okay, that's all the cheese. I'm actually going to go and turn this off. Because it's hot. Hold on a second. Talk amongst yourselves.
I'll improvise. Dog.
Okay, honey, put these on. Look at. These are my firebox. I use these. When I'm doing the smoking.
Now what I do?
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
So just hold the bun and just hold it over here. All right, we're going to start scooping these on. And so I gave her these, oh boy, I gave her these like fireproof gloves.
You want one?
I think you need
some. You want one? Nope. And that's it. They're going to be messy, you know. There's no doubt.
Oh, that one broke.
Okay. Well, that's okay.
I think I broke it.
That's the key. See, these gloves I got.
There's a glove on there.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'll get it.
He fell over.
That's okay. One of them fell over. It's no big deal.
So, Mom, do you have anything to say to beginning mothers out there for Mother's Day?
Don't have kids.
Don't have kids.
That's too late.
They're already mothers.
That's a
joke. Enjoy them while they're young because they grow fast.
And once they start talking, it's all over.
It's all over.
Talking and walking, your life is going to change. Not that.
But it's the best job in the world.
Oh, you think?
Oh, yes.
I sell potato chips for a living. I think that's the best job.
Being a mother's the best job in the world.
You heard it here.
As you can see, it should be a real simple, easy meal. But it could be some drama.
Especially when it's scorching hot outside.
And they look to be a little bit more well done than I wanted. So again. Oh, Lord have mercy on my soul. Okay, hold on a second.
Oh my gosh, it's ready.
Dip, potato chip.
That's okay.
Yeah, it'll be
all
right.
You need to see all the
yeah, so
that can happen.
I don't. I edit when I have a tongue twister like I did earlier today, but what you see is what you get.
That's what happens.
And we're going to eat this. So
yeah,
we'll
eat it.
This is what we do. We cook food and I show you how I do it. Mainly so you can learn what to do and what not to do.
I mean,
I'm not really informative, but. And then we go in the house and we eat it. cough. That's it. Steakums. Call them what you want. It's pretty simple. It's pretty easy. Obviously, the more you do, the more difficult anything is going to be on the Blackstone. If I was professional, I might have done one or two and made them real fancy. Add onions, add peppers, add a different kind of cheese, different kind of rolls, whatever you want to do. But they're simple, pretty inexpensive. I'd say maybe $15, $20 at the very most, and four of us are going to eat pretty good. Thanks for watching. If anybody does, I got two more subscribers since last time. Thumbs up, comments. Thank you very much.